AVtv is a product of the AV journalism class produced for the students of Amador Valley High School. The views expressed on the show do not represent the views of AVHS teachers, admin, or PUSD personnel.
Good morning, Dons. Hope you are having a great day. Today is Thursday, September 21st, and I'm Grace.
And I'm Amog, and we are your AVtv hosts for the seventh show of the 2023-2024 school year.
Last week's Centennial celebrations brought a sea of purple and gold pride throughout the festivities.
Especially Friday with the Centennial Parade and Pigskin.
Don't forget the game. We here at AVtv wanted to send out a congratulations to the varsity football team for their big win against Monta Vista. And good luck for their game tomorrow against Foothill.
Did you see how many people we had coming out to Pigskin? Checking out the booths and food? And what about the student section at the game? Our amateur pride really showed through.
There are so many more aspects to the Centennial celebrations, and here to recap the occasion are AVtv reporters Audrey Coombs and Max Cuey. Let's check it out!
Amador Centennial Committee combined every aspect of Amador life into 10 different events spanning 3 days, all created to celebrate the 100 years of history and Dawn spirit. Pleasanton's Museum on Main started off the three-day celebration with a wine and cheese reception on its front lawn with live music played by current Amador band students, drinks, foods, and a lively spirit filled with smiles. With 250 Amador alumni and friends in attendance, the evening offered an opportunity for graduates to catch up and reunite. The museum opened an exhibition on August 29th, celebrating Amador Centennial. AV alumni and current and retired teachers visited to memorialize and tell stories about their time at Amador, showcasing how change across the decades shapes how students are able to learn and thrive today, and how past students and staff can shape the school's future. Over 150 graduates were offered the opportunity to tour the campus and reminisce old memories while getting a glimpse of the new changes around the school. Led by current students, alumni saw how Amador's activities and culture transformed over the years. Sharing stories and visiting classrooms, every tour brought back a bit of history to share. Amador's dazzling Centennial Parade brought nostalgia with a touch of tradition. Complete with floats, teams, clubs, and a plethora of hot rods, the parade started at the Veterans Hall and headed north on Main Street towards Amador Valley, with students, teachers, and alums lining the streets to watch. With such a historic event to a wide range of audience members, the parade offered a chance for different parts of the community to come together as one. Bringing more visitors than ever before, Amador's annual Pigskin Festival Friday afternoon had a centennial twist, with students, alums, staff, and community members coming out to participate in the festivities. The event offered exposure to the many different clubs and teams at Amador, an opportunity to raise money for equipment and activities for the coming school year, and a way to show off what the organization is about for attendees. Saturday's Pancake Breakfast, hosted by Amador's Friends of Music, brought together alumni, teachers, and students for a community meal to add to Amador's celebration of 100 years. Amador's marching band, choir, and cheer all performed for the audience that gathered over the morning, as well as an alumni band. Current and past administrators gave welcoming speeches to the crowd. After the pancake breakfast, the crowd shifted to the library for a panel where alumni of varying classes shared their stories about Amador and Pleasanton during their time, and it featured author Donna McMillan's book, Pleasanton in the 1950s and 60s. Thank you to all students, staff, and alumni who made the Centennial celebration possible. Here's to a new era, Dons. Let's make it the best of it.
If you want to read more, go to amadorvalleytoday.org for more stories and photos from the Centennial celebrations.
With last week's football game still on our mind, don't forget that tomorrow is the rivalry game against Foothill here at Amador. Show up in your purple and gold, Dons, to support our fellow football players.
And tickets to the game can be purchased at bit.ly/AVFootballTickets or on the QR code on the screen. Now we have our first commercial.
Are you interested in STEM? Guest speakers, field trips, fun physics activities, and encouraging young women? Join STEM Up.
Here's ASB with this week's announcements from leadership. Let's check it out.
Hi, Dons. This week is Rivalry Week, meaning we got a big game on Friday. Don't forget, it's Dawn Deck Out. And at school, if you're Dawn Decked Out, you have the chance to win this trophy in your fourth period class. Also, the game is free for all students with ASB.
And don't forget, the Dawn Squad rap releases at 12:30 p.m. tomorrow, so make sure to watch that at the beginning of lunch.
Homecoming sales have started this week at $45 for students with ASB and $55 without ASB.
Ticket sales go up $10 each week with sales ending October 6th. Get them before they're gone. To access the HOKO packet, go to bit.ly/AVHSHOKO or scan the code on the screen and make sure to have your student ID when purchasing tickets.
Grace, did you see the performance and reveal of this year's Mr. Amador Boys at lunch last Wednesday?
Yes, I did. And if you're like me, you might be wondering what Mr. Amador is all about. With more information, here are AVTV reporters Cora Curtin and Ritika Gupta.
Last Wednesday at lunch, the Mr. Amador Boys for the 2023-2024 school year put on a performance to reveal who they were to all students. Mr. Amador is an annual male pageant and fundraiser for the George Marks Children's House, which provides care for terminally ill children.
Yeah, I think that through COVID, we lost a little bit of energy behind Mr. Amador and what it's all about and some of the traditions that we had with Mr. Amador. So I'd like to see those come back.
This year, there are 10 boys, all supported by a team of directors, volunteers, and two staff advisors who produce all the events from start to finish. Mr. Amador runs multiple events throughout the year, finishing off with the main show and silent auction at the end of the year.
We do the grams that you can send to people you want to send them to. We have the links that we do. We do caroling. We go to restaurants and do stuff there. We go to small businesses. We do a lot of stuff.
All proceeds go directly to the George Marks Children's House, and the winner is the boy who raises the most money for the house. With all the events students can expect, Mr. Amador's team hopes they can raise more money to support the cause.
It was super heartwarming to see the whole audience come together as a community, saying amounts such as $100, $200, and it was just really nice to see that they had our backs and wanted to support the George Marks Children's House as much as we did.
This has been Cora Curtin with AVTV News.
Now we have another commercial. Okay, Dons, it's time for our weekly trip around the campus. This week, AVTV reporter Audrey Coombs went out and found more news, announcements, and other information that you need to know.
And she put it all together in this week's Around the Campus in 60 Seconds. Let's check this out.
Hey Dons, I'm Audrey, and I'm here to take you around the campus in 60 seconds. Seniors, next Thursday, September 28th, during lunch in front of the NPR, Jostens representatives will be coming for cap and gown graduation orders. You can place an order next Thursday during lunch, or you can order online at jostens.com or on the QR code on the screen. You may have seen colleges in the quad during lunch. If you would like to see the list of dates of your favorite colleges visiting our campus, like Rice University, Vanderbilt, and UC Santa Barbara, you can go to bit.ly/4617F1K. Seniors, if you have not turned in your senior service hour contracts, they have extended the due date to Monday, September 25th. Make sure to turn it in into the office to acknowledge your requirements. The form can be found at bit.ly/3PS1PV1 or on the QR code on the screen. Freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and new seniors, if you've missed Picture Day, there is a makeup opportunity on September 29th. This has been Audrey Coombs with Around the Campus in 60 Seconds.
Dons, don't forget how important it is to stay connected. You can find out everything going around campus by going to amadorvalleytoday.org or follow us at AVHSinfo on Instagram.
In addition, don't forget the leadership Instagram at AVHSDons, where you can find all the Spirit Weeks and other ASB activities going around campus.
Well, that's all we have for today. Make sure you hang around for today's birthday grams and check back in with us next Thursday for more news, announcements, and profiles. Thanks for joining us, and remember, Dons,
it's always a beautiful day here at Amador.
What? clear a path as I keep on walking. Ain't no stopping in this dirty, filthy, rotten, nasty little world we call a home. They get Mickey's popping, ain't no option for my partner. So they resort to scams and robbing. Take away stress, we ganja copping. Blow it all out, it's all forgotten.